man seeking power over another, one looking to remain the pound-for-pound champ. While the other tries to shock the boxing world once again.
I like what I'm seeing from Horn. He's not intimidated at all.
Their struggles defined by their destination, shaped by determination and will. These two men have traveled distinctly different paths in their search for supremacy from two different corners of the world. Tonight, their paths collide here on the most famous strip in the world, where their grit and their legacies will be on display. Who will ascend to ultimate domination? Crawford, Horn, next.
These are the days that Vegas was built for. Throngs of supporters from both sides, pockets full of cash, fervor for their guy, and this place that has often defined the greats in the sport. The MGM Grand Garden Arena. It had Holyfield Tyson II through the Oscar years, through the Mayweather years, and now a new crop of champs, Crawford and Horn. The tail of the tape and size an overriding factor in this fight, or will it be when balanced against the incredible skill and athleticism of Terrence Crawford? Note the CompuBox superlative that you see there. Power, shot, accuracy. Crawford is exceptional, landing 48%. Horn, just under 36%. His upset of Manny Pacquiao, somehow he only landed 14% of his total punches and yet mauled and roughed up Pacquiao for the close win. It has been a while since Bud Crawford entered first, was the challenger. But entering the ring first, not the norm for a guy who many argue is the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world. When asked about it, Bud said, the bell's gonna sound the same when it rings, no matter. I'm just gonna leave the ring last. Here he comes, Terrence Bud Crawford from Omaha, Nebraska. Look at the talent he's been up against in recent fights. And he's done it all. Most recently making history as the undisputed junior welterweight champion. A two-division world champion trying to grab division number three here. Slow, calm, and cool, handling it all with aplomb. His longtime trainer, who's lovingly referred to as Bo Mack, big man who's stepping up in the ring right now, said, this is the takeover at 147 pounds. And Jeff Horn just happens to be the first victim. Great reception for America's best, Bud Crawford, looking for history, trying to become only the sixth man to win at lightweight, at junior welterweight, and now if he wins tonight, a welterweight champion. Notable three-division champions. Remember, folks, we just had history made this year on ESPN when Vasily Lomachenko was the fastest to ever do it. Only 12 professional fights for the great Lomachenko. It'll be 33 for Crawford, but look at the company he would be in with Oscar and Floyd and Manny. And now, the Grand Garden Arena, as it has done for year after year, welcomes the belt holder. From Brisbane, Queensland, Australia. The former Olympian, the unbeaten, the conqueror of Manny Pacquiao, the WBO welterweight champion. His U.S. debut still seeking respect, Jeff Horn arrives. And there have been plenty of Aussies who have traveled here to Vegas. And all week long, we have felt their presence. The 30-year-old who was bullied as a teenager, her pursued boxing, made the Olympics, worked as a high school phys ed teacher, never stopped winning, no matter the adversity, including in 2016 when his larynx was caved in during a sparring session and he had to have a titanium plate surgically placed in his neck. Australia's real-life Rocky, Jeff Horn. Both unbeaten, both champions. For the WBO Welterweight World Championship, here's Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, Nevada, USA, International Boxing Hall of Fame promoter Mr. Bob Arum and Top Rank Incorporated are proud to present, live on ESPN+, the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBO Welterweight Championship of the World. And it's all brought to you by GEICO and sanctioned by the Nevada State Athletic Commission. Chairman Anthony A. Marnell III, Executive Director Bob Bennett, WBO President, Supervisor tonight at ringside, Francisco Paco Barcarcel. The three judges assigned, Guido Cavalieri, Bert Clements, and Adam Height. And the man in charge of the action at the bell, World Championship veteran referee Robert Byrd. And now the officials are ready. The fighters are in the ring, and they are ready. So for the thousands in attendance and the millions around the world who wish they could be here, ladies and gentlemen, let's get ready to rumble! Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, with his trainers Brian McIntyre and Eso Diegues, wearing purple with white, officially weighing in at 146 and one half pounds. His professional record is a perfect one. 32 victories out of 32 fights, 23 wins by knockout. He's tonight's challenger from Omaha, Nebraska, USA, the former lightweight world champion and former undisputed junior welterweight champion of the world, Terrence Bud Crawford. And across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner with his trainer, Glenn Rushton, wearing black with orange, official weight 147 pounds. This 2012 Olympian now has an unbeaten record of 19 fights, 18 victories, including 12 wins by knockout with one even. From Brisbane, Queensland, Australia, presenting the reigning, defending, undefeated WBO welterweight champion of the world, Jeff the Hornet.
Gentlemen, you had your instructions in the dressing room. The only thing I'm going to give you, a few reminders now. First and foremost, I want you to watch your head. Second of all, anything on the band here, it's going to be good. Anything on the band here, it's going to be good. I'm going to give you guys clear instructions, and that's what I want you to do. You understand? You're both professionals, world-class, championship caliber, and that's how I want you to conduct yourself in this ring. That said, Mr. Horn, Mr. Crawford, gentlemen, let's do this.
Remember last summer in Australia, that Rocky Balboa, yo Adrian moment I did it when Jeff Horn dedicated that fight to his wife, Joe. Now a proud mother, of their little six-month-old baby, and she has come here. The family has come here to Vegas to see this. The great challenge to take on the simply sublime, excellently skilled Terrence Bud Crawford. We are underway for the world title fight. Crawford and Horn. And let it be known, third man inside the rope. So credible, but a concern for Jeff Horn this week because the referee is right now wants to be able to get work done on the inside.
There you go. You see right there, right out the gate, Terrence is controlling distance. Every time Horn steps in, he gets out just far enough, and he tries to counter just like there.
Getting after it pretty early here. Remember, Horn is switch, or Crawford is switch hitter, as he's southpaw now.
He usually starts conventional and goes southpaw. In this case, he started southpaw.
Here we go.
Their plan is that Horn will jump into a right hook.
That's a good plan. It's the check hook because Horn lunges in just like that with his head.
Oh, Horn comes in with a right hand that lands flush on Crawford.
And that's the shot I'd be worried about early on with Crawford. Sometimes he gets hit early on with big shots. And that, you saw Horn drop low like he was going to the body and looped a looping right hand and caught Crawford bagging out.
Back comes there back again. In and there's Crawford that does check that right hand hook from that southpaw position.
But one of the things that Horn does well is he throws his combinations, and guess what? He finishes them as well. It doesn't matter if he gets hit or not. He's going to finish his combination, and that's dangerous for, Crawford.
It's also noticeable, especially compared to last summer, Tim, and we understand the weight issue yesterday on the scale for Jeff Horn. His body has changed. He's far more muscular and cut up than the Jeff Horn that defeated Manny Pacquiao.
Absolutely. He's strong. He put on some muscles on.
He's been working with a nutritionist. He definitely has a different body. Not as skinny as he quite thought.
Terrence off the mark. Right there. It's hard to judge Horn's movement. Horn just doesn't attack straight on. He does every now and then, but he gives you a lot of movement in front. Different looks. Him switching up, going to the outside. That's what Horn is pretty good at, disguising his attacks.
It's a contrast in styles. It's also a contrast in the type of characters they are. One guy came to the sport because he was bullied mercilessly. The other guy got tossed out of at least five schools for basically being a bully.
Well, it's funny. He's been bullied. Now he's trying to be the bully in the ring.
I don't know if that's
ironic.
Irony or destiny.
Pretty good looking opening round here. And good exchange there as Crawford able to land. Horn had the big right hand. Crawford had a couple good combinations, including the work to the belt. All right, let's size these up in the eyes of the two-division world champion sitting with us, Timothy Bradley. Let's talk the good and the bad for Jeff Horn.
All right, you know what? I'm just going to go straight to the back. Cuts easy. You know, it's the opening bell. Terrence didn't land any really clean shots, a few of them. But you know what? I'm looking to see him actually give Horn a cut, probably midway point or anytime early because Horn has thin skin, and I've seen him get cut in the past.
Suffered against Pacquiao a cut. Also suffered a cut December 13th against Gary Corcoran, his title defense. And as for Bud Crawford?
All right, Mr. Crawford. Hooks from the middle sometimes. You saw him throwing the right hooks. Sometimes he exposes himself when he leaves himself out there with the hook. He's open. He's available for a right hand. Just put it like that. And you saw Horn land the right hand a couple of times during that last round.
Three-time Fighter of the Year, the current 2017 ESPN Fighter of the Year, also been honored by the Boxing Writers of America. To carry the weight from lightweight up to welterweight and win a crown. That is what he's trying to do tonight. The American from Omaha, Bud Crawford, round number two.
Here's Horn coming in, trying to land a right hand.
And there was that opportunity for that right hook.
Watch your head.
As Horn came charging in.
The way you beat a softball, you got to land that right hand. Kryptonite to a softball. Straight right hand, looping right hand. Change it, change the trajectory on it. Go down to the body, to the head. Loop the shot sometimes. any way to get that right hand at home against the softball.
Brian McIntyre, a.k.a. Bo Mack, is the trainer of Bud Crawford. Bernardo, what was he saying to Bud at the end of that last round?
He told Bud he's got to move his feet. He's got to avoid the burst that Jeff Horn tries to come in with, but not moving straight back. He's got to look for angles and not straight back. That's the key.
But still trying to figure out the timing of Horn because he's in and out.
He's very awkward.
Very awkward.
And very aggressive, very awkward as he switches.
Let him go, let him go.
But you see right there, the veteran tactic, tie up.
Stop.
You don't like what's going on, tie your man up.
Got it.
Robert Burns going to take control of the situation right away. He's very, very direct in the pre-fight meetings with both the Charges and the Chief Seconds.
Terrence still trying to have a hard time finding that rhythm. See, he can't even land that jab right now. And every time Horn steps in, he likes to body up with you, throw you off balance. Don't allow you to let your combinations or your counters go. He gets close to you.
Left hand to the body from Crawford.
That's great. That's how you weaken a stronger guy. A bigger guy like Horn.
Undoubtedly a bigger guy. Naturally the bigger man. Not the better athlete. Not the more skilled fighter. Thus the left hand that landed moments ago with the reaction time of Crawford. It's a left hand that comes in from Horn, and then they tie up on the inside again. Is somebody willing to work free?
All right. Now you see the transition. Terrence now, he was walking forward. He sees that
No.
Horn doesn't fight that well bagging up. When you put pressure on him, there are holes and opportunities. He can't get greedy, though. Horn will fire back at him.
There's Horn trying to get to work on that belt line on the inside. Robert Byrd's going to earn his paycheck tonight, that's for sure, the referee. Trying to come with a left uppercut as Horn came forward. End of two in our world title fight. There's that body shot, that last round from Bud Crawford. That was the signature punch of that second round.
Absolutely, and those shots will take effect later on in the fight.
We're listening to Glenn Rushton instilling yet more confidence in Jeff Horn, telling him how well he did. Rushton's an interesting character, part Tony Robbins, part Chuck Norris.
Let him go. There you
made
go.
A fortune in real estate. He's a karate teacher by trade.
He's an unbelievable media darling down in Australia. There's been so many feature stories done on him, the book on Jeff Horn, major motion picture coming out, all that centering on the relationship of trainer to fighter. That time he came forward and Bud nailed him.
Right hook.
Charging in with a right hand, and now they exchange in the middle of the ring. Bud, more the aggressor that time, doubling up the jab, trying to come with a straight left hand. Horn fires back. Good stuff here.
Now Terrence sees the opportunity that once he counters, Horn steps back with his hands down to try to reset. And he's following him out with combinations that time. Great adjustment.
Horn throws his punches, falls in, and looks to sort of bully on the inside.
There was another right hand from Horn that came in there.
He's sniping him on the way in.
Stop.
And
stop.
For an American audience, the perception of Horn is formed against Manny.
Correct.
And what Crawford says is, do not mistake me with Manny Pacquiao. I am bigger, I am stronger, I am in my prime.
There is Miss Deborah, Bud Crawford's mother. Outstanding feature story on ESPN.com, written by our Mark Kriegel this week, detailing the dynamic relationship between Deborah and her son, and all that Bud Crawford overcame to arrive to this mountaintop of a career.
There it is. Terrence Crawford followed him out with straight punches.
Horn willing to still come through the front door. Makes it fun, doesn't it? Snapping that jab is Crawford off the right hip. Straight in his Horn again.
Right,
he only knows one way. And it is a fan-friendly, TV-friendly style.
See those heads come together?
Yep. Remember, cuts are always a concern with Jeff Horn.
If you recall, Horn got cut in training camp last night, sparring with headgear.
That was 3 weeks prior to his December title defense. Just falling forward that time. Defensive flaw. Crawford couldn't take advantage, but a left hand hits the mark. And now a pop jab. And a good left hand and a combination from the American.
Well, you know who's more fundamentally sound is Terrence Crawford. He's making Horn pay for all his mistakes, dropping his hands, moving out at close distance, close range.
Excellent round from Bud Crawford.
And you see the swelling already over the right
blood.
Eye.
You got some blood over the right eye.
Miss Deborah loves it.
She made Crawford who he is. It was the her withholding respect and affection and acknowledgement made him the fighter he is.
When you hold him, you just gotta stay on him, start sliding around.
Yeah, when he's the tall him, Adam.
You gotta slide around him. Can't stand in front of this guy. Slide around him. You're going well.
Adam?
One clean hit will change all the
time. Watch this right hand from Bud Crawford, champ.
Well, there you go. Boxing 101, when you coming in with your head going past your knee. Get hit with a check hook from Terrence. Get another look at it right here. Terrence following him out. Fundamentally making mistakes. Dropping his hands as he's pulling away. And Terrence is smart enough to follow him and land that 1-2.
They put a grease on that brow of the right eye of Jeff Horn.
Stop,
round
pushing.
Number four back, for the welterweight championship. CompuBox tallying things up. The power punches in the last round, dominating round for the American Bud Crawford, landing 17 power punches, 46 of those he's thrown. We noted that earlier in our tale of the tape. If there is one stat you look at with Bud Crawford, it's his accuracy of power punches. He's dynamic with it. Joe Cortez, longtime referee here in Vegas, our unofficial judge ringside tonight. He has Crawford up 3-0.
No.
You know what this fight reminds me of?
What's that, Tim?
Ricky Hatton, Floyd Mayweather.
How so?
Ricky Hatton was trying to get close, trying to get to the body of Mayweather. And guess what? Mayweather finessed him. Kind of what Terrence is doing right now. Letting him run
go,
in the
Joe,
shots.
Letting him
fall into punches.
Free up your hands.
Mayweather, setting traps for him.
Mayweather also ended it with one clean shot.
Fight's not
check,
over yet.
A check
stop,
hook.
Stop.
Yes. As he was coming in, lunging in, similar to Jeff Horn. As the fight go on, fighters weaken. And those are your opportunities when you land shots that you were landing earlier. Guess what? They hurt a lot
go,
more.
Let him go, Jeff. Let him go.
Later on in the fight.
I mean, there's nothing that Horn is doing here that's going to slow down Bud Crawford later in the fight. He's not working the body.
No.
He's not even necessarily winning the strength battle when it comes to these wrestling matches. Not.
That's a very good point and should be noted because we talked so much about that being the one way he could go about his business.
Crawford was insistent when I spoke, I'm not nearly as small as you guys think I am coming up in this division. I mean, his contemporaries and the amateurs are now welterweight champs or have been welterweight champs, and he's not awed by them at all. The only guy who's a bit younger was Errol Spence, but he's already plotted out ways he's going to beat each of them. His move to welterweight was not a casual one. It was pretty thought out. And if you look at his back, he's a welterweight.
Broad and muscular. He also has reach. Just beyond his measurable height. Another good lead left hand from the Nebraskan. And he looks confident right now.
He'll be slow and steady.
Let's check in with Adnan Burke and Andre Ward.
All right, Tats, thank you very much. Bud Crawford so far is just relentless with that precision. How impressed have you been with the way he's dictating this fight so far?
Well, it's just the way we talked about in the beginning. I think it's playing out just the way we predicted. The fight for the first couple of rounds was nip and tuck. It's tight. Horn is hard charging. Crawford is trying to box and get his range and start to, you know, get comfortable in the ring. But then all of a sudden, you start to see class showing. You start to show the difference in skill. Crawford is slowly starting to pull away. He's countering. He's leading. He's doing it all. But Horn is still dangerous until the final bell.
Yeah, Jeff Horn has that fan-friendly style, the fact he wants to attack. And you pointed out, even though Crawford's winning, Horn has not backed down and is trying to do his best to counterpunch.
Well, that's who he is. Like we said, again, in the onset, he's not going to be turned away easy. He's got a big punch, and he's certainly trying to land it.
His trainer says he's got a grab, but right now he needs lightning.
You take punches in the round. So let's see if the fight progresses.
Tim Bradley and Mark Kriegel.
Ward, of course, retired number one pound for pound fighter in the world when he did. And now it is Bud Crawford and Vasily Lomachenko who vie for that title to be called the world's best. Tonight would be a crowning achievement to become a three-division champion if Crawford keeps up like this. Good start to round number five.
Crawford's sharp right now, just sharp shooting from the outside. He wants to stay right in front of him, blocking counter. Capitalize on all the mistakes Horn is doing. Horn is not even using his jab, guys, to get in.
He's befuddled.
It's the first problem.
He's befuddled. He's being so thoroughly outboxed, and he's even being out-wrestled, which is supposed to be his forte.
Don't do that. I don't know. There's something about skinny people. They strong. I'm not going to lie. I've been in there with a few skinny men myself, and they are physically strong.
Well, stop, guys. Stop.
Terrence showing his strength right there by bagging up Jeff Horn. Taking some of the steam out of his legs by doing that.
Stop.
One thing Horn said that Crawford didn't have in his resume is he'd never been tested as Horn was against Pacquiao. He'd never endured a ninth round as Horn did against Pacquiao. And with this skill level you're seeing with Bud Crawford, now you see why.
Well, Bud Crawford don't want to be here. If he's there, he wants to be there. He shouldn't be on the ropes like that. He's comfortable. He's in control. He knows his range now. Now he's executing his attack.
Let him go. Punch
he's winning every aspect of the ring right now. Inside, middle, outside, even a wrestling battle.
And there is the wrestling battle that Robert Byrd will bring to an end and then bring
this
these guys together.
You hold him. Don't do that. You understand what I'm saying?
Horn's breathing heavy.
Horn said, I'll test his soul. I think it's quite the opposite. I think that Crawford is testing Horn's soul.
He's pushing him around. You can see that redness above the right eye as he sends back Horn. Crawford's in control here in round five, giving the best of the Aussie. And now this thing's getting real ugly.
You okay? All right, let's go.
There was so much talk from the Horn camp. Some of it bothering Bud Crawford, saying it's just stupid. It's silly what's being said. He got the sense yesterday when we met with Bud Crawford, he wasn't in a good mood. There was a nastiness to his disposition.
Crawford tries to be dispassionate or pretend nothing bothers him. I think inside he's one of these guys who needs to feel deeply personal. He needs to feel some affront.
You've talked about the dichotomy of somebody who's a great humanitarian who's gone off to do charitable efforts in Africa compared to the guy who gets in this ring.
He enjoys hurting you.
End of story. Simply said, Mark Kriegel. And right now, he is hurting Jeff Horn.
Got to land a couple of clean shots on him and everything changes. We've got to start landing clean shots. Chest, overhands. When you go, you got to really friggin' go. You've got to keep moving around. You're breaking the rhythm well. You're up and down.
Okay, you can take it out from the end.
When you come for him, stay on him though. You've got to build some pressure onto this guy. You can't just let him sit and pick the off. Just got to keep building the pressure. Real broken rhythm pressure. Sliding around him left, sliding around him right, up and down. Hitting him from all angles. Over here, up and down.
Build the pressure.
Glenn Rushton says to Jeff Horn, Tim Bradley, when you go, you gotta really go. Get after it. Everything changes, he reminds him, when something good happens. That's exactly what happened in the 10th round against Manny Pacquiao, yes, when he was almost TKO'd in the 9th.
Yes, absolutely. Sometimes you can tell your fighter to go into harm's way, and guess what? You put him in danger zone. I think him, by doing so, by just rushing in, leaping in like that, you see Terrence get out. Too slick, too smart for that.
He also said, I want to see broken rhythm pressure. Explain that to us.
Broken rhythm pressure is basically moving in and out, herky-jerky type of style. You know, giving him different looks, giving him different fronts, thinking he's going to attack him, coming straight in, then coming off to the side with something. So just give him to see how he's dropping low. Then he attacks, changing levels.
Stop.
That's all part of it, broken rhythm. Don't stay the same. Keep moving, doing something different.
I thought Pacquiao, the Horn fight, came up against the limits of his size and his age. Right now, Horn is coming up, at least against Crawford, the limits of his talent.
Let him up.
Occasionally, you see Terrence step to Horn with his hands high, blocking, countering Horn. Right now, he's choosing to sit back and just wait on Horn to come in to catch him with a counter. But Terrence is dangerous when he steps to you.
He can walk him down.
Yes.
He can fight going backward. Horn can do one thing.
And that's come forward.
And he's paying a price for it now.
He's trying. I mean, he's giving his best foot forward.
Rushton says, you just got to land a few shots. It's a lot easier said than done, even on the inside.
Good uppercut that time from Bud Crawford. The left hand landed. Good body shot as well. Remember, he scored his undisputed championship with a body shot knockout of Julius Ndongo.
Yes, and I want to see more body punches from Terrence.
Let him go, Jeff.
He'll weaken Horn even more if he landed more body shots. He hit him with the chin shots. He's taking the well, but those body shots will have an effect later on.
One of the things you're seeing with Crawford is a guy who's completely at home with whatever the terms of combat are. You want to go inside? You try to, like, rough me up? Okay, I'm good there. You want to be in the middle of the ring? Okay, I'm good there.
I told y'all it was like fighting the Black Panther in there. No, he was no joke when I sparred him. Now he's going downstairs.
That hurt.
That took the air out of Horn right there. You see,
that was the Ndongo shot, something very close to that.
Here we go.
When you get to the championship rounds, you'll see what those body shots will do or have done. If it goes that long.
Halfway through the title fight. And Crawford in control.
You can't do this, Jay. You can do this. I know you can beat this guy. You can do this. Let's do it for Isabel. Come on. Let's dig it.
Let's
go up again.
Come on.
Tune into his movement. You're starting to pick him up as he moves.
Here's the uppercut here inside. This is the home where Horn's supposed to have success. Nope, I don't think so. Look at the short uppercut and precision. How calm Terrence was. Terrence Crawford was to see that opportunity and land that uppercut.
Mentioned the Black Panther in making your analogy. Chadwick Boseman is sitting ringside for this fight on ESPN Plus. Oh, we have the award-winning actor with us, Mark Wahlberg, also here tonight, as is Rick Ross and many NFL stars to come see the great Bud Crawford.
See a sense of urgency in Horn. He's trying hard. He landed a couple of, I think it was like a, it was like jabs. Terrence early on surprised Terrence with those shots.
We heard Glenn Rushton say, you can do this, Jeff. You can do this. Bernardo, what is BOMAC saying in the corner of Crawford?
BOMAC just wants Terrence to keep working that body, wear him down, and that's all he wants.
Timmy, you say you want to see more of that. Mark?
Yes, ooh, look at the head. Almost come quick. But you see how Terrence got his head out the middle right away and leaned back.
Yeah, but it was worth noting that Rushton gave him a motivational speech, not a strategic speech in the corner.
I think that's a very good note by you, because I think it demands it at this moment.
But it also means that he's out of strategic options.
Correct. They need to will something to happen.
Yes.
They need that miracle. They need to find that magic that they found somehow late against Pacquiao. But this isn't Manny Pacquiao in the autumn of his career. This is a prime Bud Crawford.
They need Terrence to make a mistake. And I don't think that's going to happen.
You don't see that often out of Crawford. He is fundamentally sound, and he is athletically superior.
Yes, he is. Warren having a little success right there with that double right hand. He lands it again on Crawford as Crawford leans into the line of fire with that right hand.
Good short work on the inside with that left hand from Crawford.
See, everything is all set up by the jab from Crawford.
Lead left hand from Crawford, and you just don't see Jeff Horn with that desire to come downhill every attempt as he did in rounds one, two, and three.
We call that lead left hand that he threw. He threw the jab and then threw the lead left hand and followed with a jab, a changeup, just like baseball. You don't see that combination also.
Get your hand free. Get your hand free. Let him go, Jeff. You got him hooked. Let him go.
Goes with the left hand to the body as well. And then as Horn stepped forward, another left hand that connects to the body. Oh, left uppercut nearly tagged him solid as he came forward that time. Welterweight championship on the line, and more world championship action will be coming your way on ESPN. There is Zerto Ramirez in the crowd there. Shakur Stevenson, the young prospect with a big smile sitting right in front of him. But Zerto Ramirez is an outstanding super middleweight. The first Mexican to win a super middleweight world title. He's fighting June 30th on ESPN. And then this guy, Jose Ramirez, one of the great stories in boxing. As he won a world title back in New York on ESPN and now fights July 7th against Danny O'Connor. A couple world title fights coming up June 30th and July 7th. Zerto Ramirez and then Jose Ramirez, the junior welterweight champion. The most recent junior welterweight champion, the undisputed junior welterweight champion, is calm as could be. Look at him. So relaxed, in control, in command, and dominating Jeff Horn the way we see it right now.
Yeah, and I'm thinking he's saying to himself, what is holding this young man up?
By the way, there was so much made of the judging in the fight against Pacquiao for Jeff Horn. And then there was the review of the scores and the Pacquiao controversy that ensued. In terms of the contract for this fight, it was demanded by the Horn camp that an Australian judge would be here in Vegas, and that is the case with Adam Hyde. Then there is Bert Clements, the veteran, incredible U.S. judge, and the third judge is Guido Cavalieri from Italy. An American, an Italian, and an Australian are judging this fight ringside.
I don't think it's going to come down to the judges, nor is it going to come down to the referee, who's the subject of so much debate. What would Robert do? What would Robert Byrd do? I think that Crawford has actually nullified that. It's not that they're not allowed to clinch and to hold. It's just that Crawford has actually had his way with the part of the fight that was supposed to be Horn's greatest advantage.
Speaking of referees, we have one of the veterans sitting with us ringside tonight. Joe Cortez is our ESPN Plus unofficial judge, and he sees a clean sweep for Crawford.
Crawford switched back right-handed. And he did that because he wanted to land that left hook to the body.
Let him go.
And he did.
Punching it out.
As he has placed left hands all night long. Now orthodox is Bud Crawford. There is the left hook. And this is where he can be most dangerous, Mark.
When Crawford goes to the right hand, that's when he's looking for the knockout.
Let's see if he finds it here. Just over a minute to go in round number eight.
All right. Stop.
From that right hand stance now. That right hand's his power punch. That left hook is deadly. There it is as it backs up Jeff Horn. And now back to southpaw for Omaha's best.
Now the right hand right there that snuck in.
Horn trying to be aggressive for a moment, Timmy, to your point.
Yeah, it was a right hand. He kind of lunges forward, brings his back foot forward like there.
Watch your head.
And he throws the right hand. And occasionally, Crawford will lay on his, see him lay on that left side.
Punching between punches and a flush left hand. And here comes Bud on the attack. Half minute to go in round eight. Can he finish him? Strafing shots to the head. Horn is hurt. Body shot lands with the right hand as well. Off balance is the Aussie. Left hand came just short.
Got 5 seconds. 5 seconds. Dig day, Brave, Dig day.
Brave. Strike. Relax.
Breathe
it in.
You've got to stay on the whole time. We're all good. He's good.
He's good.
Good. He's good. He's good.
You've just got to stay very aware all the time. Mentally.
This is how it ended. And you hear the bell there. Tim Bradley, the champ, in total control there.
Champ definitely in total control. Caught him with the straight left hand. Might have got the feet tangled up. No, that was a solid, solid left hand right there. Wobbled the champion.
Two division world champion, Bud Crawford, against the welterweight champion, Jeff Horn. Will he soon be a three division champion?
With a round like that in evidence, if you're Glenn Rushton and you love your fighter, how long do you let this thing go on?
He's a tough guy, is Horn.
He's the champion. You let it go on.
He got caught with a left hand, thrown off balance again. Remember round number 9, that was the round when Pacquiao nearly got rid of him as well. But Horn fought back, dominated the finish of that fight to go on and win a controversial decision.
Good point, but if there's no strategic alternative, it's just motivational speak.
Yeah.
Good luck.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Young man worked hard to get the title. Let him fight it out.
Let him out. Punch it, get out.
You never know when you're going to cash a lottery ticket, too, in this game.
That's the beauty about boxing. Only takes one punch.
He has been thoroughly dominated. He has been hurt. He has been outclassed. But all it takes is one go of it. And he's still coming forward.
Yeah, Crawford knows he's weakening. He's stepping to him. He knows that he doesn't have the power on his punches like he did early in the fight. So now he's stepping to him, and he's making him pay every chance he gets.
Just a note, Rushton's had this guy since he was 19 years old. He helped him become a man. He's helped him immeasurably in his life. At some point, it's not even about tonight. It's about 5 years from now. It's about 10 years from now. You saw his wife and his kid at ringside. It's a consideration. And if he can't win the fight, it's something. I'm not expecting Jeff Horn to quit, but I'm expecting his corner to at least factor that in. I don't think we're there yet.
I get you, but it's
a consideration.
I disagree because he's still in there fighting. He's still in there trying. Terrence is sharpshooting right now.
Big left hand, right hook, uppercut, sends him back. Seconds to go here in round number 9. Let's see what Crawford does with it. Here he comes. Backs him up with a left hand again. Horns in the corner. Uppercut lands. Crawford on the attack. That's it. It's over. It's over. We celebrated an undefeated triple count winner in New York today. And now a triple division world champ here in Vegas. Bud Crawford on top of the world.
Good.
America's best just put the champ from down under over and out. TKO victory, Crawford. There's Miss Deborah, family and friends, ready to celebrate deep into the night here in Vegas.
And it was a righteous stoppage, I thought. What did you think, champ?
That's what the ref is there for. Absolutely.
Good job by Robert Byrd. There was concern from the Horn camp about the role he would play today. He was just fine, wasn't he?
I'm just going to let everybody know right now, the welterweight division got a new monster in it. His name is Terrence Crawford. Y'all better get to work.
He is the judge.
He is tough for anybody in the welterweight division.
We have been blessed on ESPN to watch Vasily Lomachenko. You just saw Bud Crawford. Who's the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world? They are both just awesome right now. Let's make it official. They are ready to party here in Vegas for the kid from the U.S. of A. Here's Michael Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here at the MGM Grand of Las Vegas, referee Robert Byrd steps in and calls a halt to the bout. The official time, 2 minutes 33 seconds of round number 9. The winner by TKO victory, and now the new undefeated WBO welterweight champion of the world, Terrence Bud Crawford.
His trainer, Brian McIntyre, a.k.a. BOMAC, said, this is the takeover at 147 pounds, and Jeff Horn just happens to be the first victim. Here's how he victimized him in round number 9, the first knockdown, Tim Bradley.
There it is. Crawford coming forward, landing combinations. He lands it looks like an overhand left hand on Horn. There it is, combinations there, he's affected. Moving back, fatigueness is setting in.
And then the stoppage.
And then the stoppage. Head, body. Look at the precision from Terrence Crawford. Up, 1-2. Straight up. And the ref thought he saw too much there.
Watch the uppercut.
Look at that uppercut.
That left uppercut. And then backing him up and putting those two body shots in there, including the last short left hand. And Robert Byrd had seen enough. And Mark Kriegel from Omaha, Nebraska. And all that has come with it. Look at Miss Deborah.
I wouldn't want to fight Miss Deborah, would you?
Let's go up to the ring and hear from the new welterweight champion of the world, Bernardo.
Thank you very much, Joe. Terrence, about a dominant performance have we seen. What happened tonight? Because even in the wrestling, the physicality, you were the bigger man.
Well, first of all, I like to give honor to God for blessing me with this victory. And I like to dedicate this fight to my coach, Midge Miner, that passed back then. I told him I was going to do this, and I did it for him. Shout out to Triple Threat back in Colorado Springs. That's my second home away from home. And like I told y'all before, I'm strong. You know, y'all didn't believe me, and I was way stronger than him. You know, y'all kept telling me how strong he was, but y'all didn't give me enough credit, so I had to go in there and show y'all.
You did go in there and prove that tonight. What kind of statement do you think you send to the other talent at 147 that were watching you tonight?
Oh, we here. You know, like I said, my power carried up. You know, my physicality got stronger, and we here now.
You mentioned this was the takeover. What did you mean by that?
Hey, y'all try to compare me to Manny Pacquiao. You see what I just did to him.
All right. Walk me through the fight, because at the end of the 8th round, it looked like you had him hurt. Then you came out in round 9. What were the instructions in the corner when you finished?
My coach wanted me to go right-handed. I told him, I said, no, I'm going to stay left-handed. I got him. Don't worry about it. You know? So that was just the conversation that we had in the corner.
All right. 147, a lot of talent. Who does Terrence Crawford want?
I want the other champions. I want the big fights. Bob, let's make it happen.
All right. There it is, a directive to the promoter, Bob Arum, to make the big fights at 147.
It is a division loaded with talent. Keith Thurman, Errol Spence, Danny Garcia, Sean Porter. But he just dismissed one of the champions and took the belt from him. Ninth round TKO. Bernardo is with Jeff Horn.
Jeff, you fought in the United States for the first time against one of the best pound for pounders in the world. What do you take away from this fight in terms of who Terence Crawford is?
Look, he's a very good boxer. I knew he was going to be on the back foot countering. I thought I could beat him coming forward, but he clipped me a bit too much. And well done to Terence Crawford. Great fighter.
Many of us expected you to be the bigger man. It looked like he was strong in there. How did he feel?
Yeah, he was strong. He was fine. He didn't seem like a smaller guy, that's for sure. We weighed in the same thing, so good on him.
A duel of undefeated fighters, unbeaten fighters. Obviously, you're a warrior. Did you want to continue? Was a stoppage right?
Yeah, I was just slightly off balance on one of the feet. I wish I could keep going till the end, but you know, the ref said to me he's got my interests at heart, so I'm sure Joe, my wife, is happy anyway.
All right, what's next for you, Joe?
I'll just rebuild from here. We'll have to talk to the team and see what happens.
Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you.
You know, after all we heard from his camp, let it be known, there was no excuse out of Jeff Horn right there.
No.
At all. Bud Crawford's got the belt. Rick Ross is celebrating with him. What a night in Vegas. And what a great fighter America has in this guy. 33-0 with 24 knockouts and now a three-division champion. That's how he finished him. As Bud Crawford, your new WBO welterweight world champion. We'll wrap things up here from Vegas on ESPN Plus when we come back.
You see Robert Berg, the referee here, telling the head trainer Glenn Rushton for Jeff Horn, "I'm looking out for you." This was while Bud Crawford is being interviewed by Bernardo Osuna. Clearly, Horn's camp displeased the fight ended there. However, as we continue here with our post-fight coverage on ESPN+, Adnan Burke alongside the champ Andre Ward, you said to me after Jeff Horn took a knee and there was 37 seconds, there's too much time. He's not going to make it. How did you know that so clearly?
Well, if you know anything about Terence Crawford, he's a great finisher. Once he gets you hurt, he doesn't let you off the hook. There was a lot of talk about Robert Byrd before the fight, what type of job he was going to do. He did a tremendous job tonight. He stayed out of the way. He let the fight unfold naturally. And I really think the Horn camp should really be thanking Robert Byrd because he really saved him from taking further punishment. Terence Crawford was not going to let off the gas. He was going to continue to pour it on, and it was going to start to get ugly.
Jeff Horn gave a game effort tonight, but clearly was overmatched. Shutouts across the board from all the judges. How impressed were you by the work of Bud Crawford tonight?
Listen, first and foremost, hats off to Jeff Horn. He didn't quit. He didn't fold. He was just outclassed and outmatched. Terence Crawford did what we said he was going to do in the beginning of this telecast. He boxed. He had to kind of stand his ground the first couple rounds and get his respect, but then he started to pull away. To the young fighters out there, learn the craft and the art of the skill. There's a lot of talk about having a fan-friendly style. You can have a fan-friendly style and not take punishment and put on the kind of performance like Terence Crawford just did. At the end of the day, the name of the game is to take away your opponent's strength and to neutralize their weakness. And if they tell you anything different, that's fake news.
Yeah, it was remarkable precision from start to finish. Not fake news. Andre Ward did a great job tonight. Thanks,
champ. Thank
you,
man. Appreciate it.
Let's go back to Joe Tessitore. You know, Justify won the Triple Crown today. Speaking of history, Bud Crawford is a part of history as well, Joe.
That's right. Triple Crown winner in New York and an undefeated triple division winner here.